Hello, I'm Mamta. Today, we are going to take up the second part of the chapter Human Development. Let's look at the overview of developmental stages. Now, when we talk about development, we talk about stages. The first stage is the prenatal stage. Prenatal stage is a stage just after conception till the fetus is out of the womb, and that stage takes 40 weeks. Now, here we're talking about a concept which is now believed very strongly, that what the mother thinks impacts the child's growth, impacts the fetus. So every thought, every feeling goes on to the fetus on a very large scale. Now, everybody knows a pregnant lady should eat fine and should be happy. That is the reason why it is well understood. Even when we go on to the context of history, Bhagavad Gita, if you look at it, Arjun was sharing the whole concept of Chakravyuh when Abhimanyu was in the womb. And obviously, Abhimanyu heard the way to get in, but did not hear the way to get out. So that is the kind of impact that is there on the fetus. So whatever the mother thinks, each and every thought has an impact on the fetus. And imagine if the lady has any kind of illness, the kind of damage it will have on the fetus. This is the first aspect that we are considering, where we are understanding the role of teratogens. Teratogens are the environmental agents that cause deviation in the normal development. Any kind of abnormality can result in because of these teratogens. Now, they can be anything, starting from any kind of medicine which has its side effects. It can be any kind of drugs, alcohol, smoking. It can be any kind of infections, any radiations, pollutions. Also, when we talk about any tobacco use, any alcohol use has a major damage. So any illness, drugs or any substance. Apart from that, emotions and age also has an influence. When the lady is above 35 years of age, that is a very risky phase. So normally it is said that the first pregnancy should be before 35 years of age, because that is still a stable time. Otherwise, it will result in a lot of congenital abnormalities, and that will be not recoverable. So it will stay on with the child and the person for the rest of his life. Now, when we are talking about developmental stages, understand clearly that every individual develops in all the areas in every age. So first we've covered the prenatal stage. Now we'll move on to the infancy and then the other stages subsequently. But understand this fact that every individual is growing, particularly with reference to the kind of development which is universal. And also, every stage has some tasks that are to be accomplished, some goals that are to be accomplished. Only then the person will move on from one stage to the other. Sensory development happens, motor development happens. So when we talk about infancy particularly, we are looking at the motor development. Now, look at an infant of 0 to 2 years of age. Observe an infant who has just taken birth. The first thing that is important is the cry of the infant, because that is a mechanism which starts the functioning of lungs and sends on oxygen to the brain. That's a very important process. That, if not accomplished, can result in a major brain damage. The cells, the structures can be damaged, which is again irreversible. It can result in mental retardation. When we talk about infancy, we are understanding it from the perspective of milestones. That is, an infant has to start achieving certain targets for its development, because that is the fastest phase of the growth. Now, in infancy, when we look at motor development, we are understanding the first aspect is reflexes, something that the infant is having within him, the inborn, automatic, built-in responses to whatever stimuli is. So suddenly something is in the eye, the automatic reaction is closing the eye. Something hot, automatic reaction is pulling off the hand. That is the inbuilt reflexes which are there in the infant to help the infant adapt to the outside environment. Second we have is the sensory ability. Now, don't assume an infant to be a totally helpless being, because even an infant has so many powers which we are not aware of. They do have abilities which obviously build on for the rest of the 2 years. So sensory abilities are also there in the infant. That means all the sense organs are functioning. Of course, not to the capacity that are there with the adult, but looking at the vision, the infant has vision. Obviously, it takes 6 months of duration to develop to the capacity of 20/20 of adults. Infants also are able to hear mother's voice right few hours after birth. They are also able to feel pain. They are also able to sense things. And whenever they feel any discomfort, they start crying. So vision is there, but at the same time, they are color blind. They can differentiate between red and green, but the other colors take a little time to develop along, because every brain, every part of the body, every part of the sense organ is developing slowly and gradually. So it doesn't mean they don't have capacities. They have it, but yes, they are being refined with time. Let's look at the cognitive development in infants. A very famous psychologist, Jean Piaget, understood that infants are very, very active and they construct their own reality. Normally, it was assumed that, you know, it's like information just simply enters the brain of an infant from the environment and they are just helpless beings who are just processing the information. According to Jean Piaget, who did research on his own children to understand the different stages they were at and how they were developing cognitively. So we will understand Piaget's perspective, not just in infancy, we'll also cover it in childhood and in adolescence. Now, one important concept according to Piaget is object permanence. Now, for all of us, when we look at a certain object, we remember it, we have a memory of it. But do the infant also respond in the same manner? What do you think? An infant, when Piaget researched, it was understood that the object continues to exist for us, but not for the infant. So this awareness, this continuity in an object in our mind is not there for an infant. So object permanence is there for us because obviously it develops with time. Infants do not have object permanence right from the beginning. So let's look, you can even do an experiment with an infant at your home that you can just show a certain toy to the infant and then take it away. Infant will not remember that particular toy, will not cry for it. You can hide it partially or you can hide it in front of the infant. The infant will not ask for it. So I'm only talking about the initial stage. I'm not talking about the total 0 to 2 years of age because it develops gradually. The child starts having a memory of certain objects and then cry for it. For instance, when we talk about infants particularly, it has been said that first 3 years of a child's infant's life is not really remembered. Even if we look at ourselves, we do not remember first 3 years of our life because by that time the memory starts consolidating, the language starts developing, and thereafter the person remembers. Next that we have is the socio-emotional development. Now an infant is also a social being. It also wants mother as a familiar face. It also wants familiar people around it because it wants to interact and feel their warmth. It wants their presence. So a lot of times parents' presence is reflected in the infant's pleasure by cooing and gurgling, different kind of sounds that you might hear the infant making. And also by 6 to 8 months of age particularly, they start up with all these different kinds of sounds that you hear. And also for the mother's company. Most of the time, the infants wants a very close attachment to the mother, which was shown in 2 major researches. This is the concept of attachment that we are talking about. It's a close emotional bond of affection that develops between infants and their parents or the caregivers. Now, this concept of attachment was researched by a very famous study by Harlow and Harlow. Now, these two people, what they did was, they placed a baby monkeys right after birth, 8 hours after birth, in the care of a wired meshed mother and in the care of a cloth mother. So, the two mothers were taking turns, which was an experiment or toy. They were taking turns to feed the infants, the baby monkeys. Now, it was found that even if the cloth mother, it was feeding for very little time, but then the baby monkeys had much more preference for the cloth mother than the wire meshed mother. Reason being, not just food, not just the biological need, but also the attachment, the emotional bond, the warmth was very important. A lot of times it happens when the caregiver is busy, the mother or the father is busy, the infant gets very attached to the stuffed toy or gets very attached to the maid at home. That is the concept of attachment. There have been lots of researches where right after birth, the ducklings started following the experimenter. Or you've seen the context of Mowgli, when he's staying in the jungle, he starts following the animals. So right after birth, the growth period is very, very strong. So whatever sense organs are taking in at that time, the growth, it's a critical period. It just starts off and grows up very fast. This was one study. The other study that we have is by Erik Erikson, again, a very famous psychologist who studied particularly the socio-emotional development in people, how it takes place. So he understood, he in fact also gave a lot of stages when we talk about socio-emotional development across the different ages we'll study. So in infancy, he talked about the concept of trust versus mistrust. Trust here refers to, you know, when the parents are taking care of all the needs of an infant. The infant starts having this feeling that this world is a very, very secure place. So even if such an infant is left alone, will not get insecure, will not cry. On the other hand, in case the infant's needs are not understood by the parents, the infant is crying, but the parents are not able to understand and identify the reason because of which the infant is crying, then with such aspects all the time, the lack of attention, the lack of warmth, the lack of understanding by the parents, the lack of sensitivity, because the infant wants a comfort zone, a comfort level. If the infant is not given that, the infant starts feeling that the world is a very bitter place. So such children grow up to be very negative thinkers and negative personalities. That is the reason why the first few years of life are important to be understood so that they can be handled accordingly. Now let's look at the total context that we have understood today. We started from the concept of what are the stages that we need to understand, the stages where every task is accomplished. The infant starts with certain tasks. The prenatal age started with certain tasks, certain patterns of development, certain patterns of changes, where we are understanding that how the development takes place in the same state of prenatal and in the state of infancy across the different areas of development. So development is taking place simultaneously, starting from the physical development, development with the body, and then we moved on to the development that takes place in the mind, in the emotions, socio-emotional development. Of course, morality as such, when we look at it, doesn't really develop because the infant has not really started with language. Because once language starts, then thereafter, morality also develops. So we'll understand that more of it in childhood, the next stage. But looking at the overall perspective, when we talk about the stage concept, each stage is understood in detail, and then we are able to understand the impact on a child's development from the total perspective. Now let's understand this fact that infancy is a stage where the infant is interacting with the world outside. Obviously, because when the infant comes into the world, it doesn't know the world outside. So when it is interacting with the outside world, it is able to understand it, but majorly from the sensory motor perspective. And that is what Jean Piaget also talked about when he was talking about cognitive development, where he says that the world outside is understood through the sense organs of the infant. It's a sensory motor stage of Jean Piaget's cognitive development where it is understood that the sense organs are a medium for the infant to understand the world, be it the pain the infant experiences, be it the voice it hears, be it any kind of sound or any kind of vision, or any understanding of the world the infant takes in from the environment. All that is a sensory motor stage where sense organs and the motor apparatus are major role players for understanding the environment for the infant. So today we have understood the impact of environment, the impact of different kinds of development on the prenatal stage and the different goals accomplished in the prenatal stage as well as in infancy. That's about it for today. Thank you.